Under Section 107 of the Copyright Act 1976, allowance is made for fair use for purposes such as criticism, comment, news, reporting, teaching, scholarship, and research. Fair use is a use permitted by copyright statute that may otherwise be infringing.
You guys know from the very beginning of this case, I really thought Chris Proudfoot was home. I explained in detail, in absolute detail to my audience, exactly why I absolutely thought Christopher Proudfoot had come home that weekend. And for those that don't know, I'm going to explain it to you. I've been in construction. If you don't know anything about me, I've been in a lot of different things, okay? I've done a lot of different things with my life. I don't know why. It's not because I think I'm better than anybody or anything. I think it was just because I was confused and didn't know what the heck I wanted to do, okay? One of the things is my father had an electrical subcontracting company. He was a master electrician. And, you know, back in the 70s and 80s, and that's when I was being raised, okay? I was a little girl, okay? I was born in 1979 for you youngsters, and for your oldsters that thinks I'm young, that's my birth, okay? Back in them days, you didn't have the laws that you have in this day and age, okay? We don't have babysitter laws and stuff like that. So, and we don't really have, you can't bring your child to work laws, okay? So my parents weren't rich. They took me to work with them. Okay, my dad was a master electrician. So at 2 years old, don't ask me how the heck my dad didn't manage to kill me, right? Being around electrical at 2 years old. I don't think anybody would do. But you know what? I really was a good kid. I was a good kid. And I loved being with my dad, and I loved handing him tools. And I think that's how he kept me occupied all day, unbeknownst to me, is my only job was to hand him tools all day long. So at 2 and 3 and 4 years old, I knew what channel locks were. I knew what, you know, screwdrivers were. I had seen, you know, fist fights on the job site, okay, at this point. I've seen some things that... That would probably put a parent in jail now, in all fairness. Back in the days, it was completely legal, right? It was completely legal. So long story short, the one thing I'm getting with this whole story is I understand construction. I understand construction sites. This is the one thing that is kind of in my DNA from a very, very young girl, okay? Even as people want to know why, you know, with the finances, at a young age, I was balancing my father's, like, his business accounts. I was helping him prepare for taxes when I was, you know, 5 years old. Just to let you know why I have some of these experiences that I do. It's because I was taught at a young age. It wasn't out of because they wanted to teach me. It was out of, they had no place to put me, right? Daycare was too expensive for, you know, a man starting an electrical business and a woman working at a doctor's office, okay? I think back then that my mom was making $4 an hour. I mean, if that tells you anything. So it's just one of those things. So construction is the one thing that I kind of really get. It's a trait I'll always have for the rest of my life, right? But it's something I really don't, I could live without for the rest of my life as well. But construction men that go out on it, the one thing that they want to do, the one thing that you hear them talking about all week long is going home, sitting in their MFing recliner and popping a beer. That's all you ever hear them talk about all week long. So why in the world would I really believe that a man that has worked all week long on a tower crane go back to his camper when he's only 3.5 hours away from his favorite recliner and suds?